will not see him before me, or I will not see him before you. We shall all see Jesus at the same time. His coming will be visible. Stay with the preacher tonight. Walk with me. For not only will his coming be visible, but can I share with you tonight that his coming will also be audibly. Jesus will come audibly. The Bible is clear in teaching that he will come not simply to return for return's sake, but he will come with noise, and all of us will hear him. 1 Thessalonians 4:16, the Lord himself will come down from heaven with a loud command, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trumpet call of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. And so if you die in Christ, you will not go to heaven before me. You will lay asleep in the grave until Jesus come, until that trumpet will sound, where all of us will be able to hear the coming of the Lord. You understand, beloved and friends, that no sound can wake the dead but the coming of the Lord. You can even put a music box in the cemetery, and the dead will still be dead. But at the coming of Jesus Christ, I stop by to let you know tonight that that is the only sound that can raise the dead back to life. The prophet Jeremiah, referring to the end of the world, adds to this. He says, the Lord will roar from an eye. He will thunder from his holy dwelling and roar mightily against his land. He will shout like those who tread the grapes, and shout against all who live on earth. And so similarly, the psalmist in Psalm 53 says, our God comes and will not be silent. Oh, you missed the shout, brothers and sisters. Our God comes and will not be silent. A fire devours before him, and around him the greatest rages. Understand, beloved and friends, just in case there was room for doubt, the Apostle Paul also refers to this immense sound in 2 Peter 3:11. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief. The heavens will disappear with a roar. The elements will be destroyed by fire, and the earth and everything that is done in it will be laid bare. The brothers and sisters, you ought to understand tonight that Jesus will come audibly. All of us will be able to hear that great noise. All of us will be able to hear when he comes to call us home to glory. It is clear that the second coming of Christ will be thunderous, it will be loud. There will be screams and trumpets and all kinds of intense noise. Are you still with the preacher? But Jesus will come with all army of angels. Jesus will come with an army of angels. When Jesus returns, he will not be alone. Praise the wonderful name of Jesus. For the Bible says that the angels will accompany him. When the Son of Man comes in his glory and all the angels with him, he will sit on his glorious throne. Notice that that is not about some angels. Notice it is not speaking about some angels, but about all of the angels. And Daniel chapter 2 and verse 10 gives this description of the angels in heaven. Thousand upon thousands attend him. 10,000 times 10,000 stood before him. That really, beloved and friends, is a lot of angels, and they will come with Jesus. Jesus will come with his army, coming to take us home to glory. That will be audible. That will be visible. It will be literal. And I want you to know tonight, beloved and friends, that you are to be a part of that grand homecoming. You are to be on the side of the Lord when that glorious invasion takes place. Won't you want to be with Jesus? Yes, should be your answer. For this sin-cursed earth will not last forever. Can I talk to you here? This sin-cursed earth will not last forever. The war and the crime and all kinds of stuff that is happening around us is signs that are telling us that Jesus Christ is even at the door. He will come. Let us watch and be ready. He will come in the clouds of his Father's bright glory, but we know not the hour. But one thing we know for certain, he will come. Jesus will come and shook the earth. Christ's return will also shake the very foundation of the earth, as if a global earthquake was demolishing the planet. It will be thunderous. The earth will be shaken. I watch, beloved and friends, in Revelation chapter 6, 12 to 14, as he opened the sixth seal, there was a great earthquake. The sun turned black like sackcloth made of goat hair. The whole moon turned red blood, and the stars in the sky fall to the earth as figs drop from a fig tree when shaken by a strong wind. The heavens receded like a scroll being rolled up, and every mountain and island was moved from its place. What an enormous event that will be, beloved and friends. And I just stop by to tell you tonight that when Jesus comes, you are to be on the Lord's side. There is one more characteristic that the return of Christ has. Do you want me to share it with you tonight? That it will be a decisive event. You didn't hear me. Can I talk to you here? The coming of Christ will be a decisive event. You see, when Jesus comes, the world will be divided into two groups: the saved and the lost. Revelation 6, 15 and 16 describes the group of the lost as follows. Then the kings of the earth, the princes, the generals, the rich, the mighty, and everyone, both slave and free, hid in caves and among the rocks of the mountain. They call to the mountain and the rocks, fall on us and hide us from the face of him who sits on the throne and from the wrath of the Lamb. I stop by to let you know tonight, beloved and friends, that when Jesus comes, if you are not on the Lord's side, then you will be running to the rocks and to the mountain for them to fall on you and to hide you from the face of him who comes. Can I talk to you here? Whether you believe in the second coming of Christ or not, the second coming of Christ will be literal. It will be visible. It will be audible. It will come like a mighty thunder. And I want you to know tonight, brothers and sisters, that if you haven't made Jesus your Savior and Lord, and he comes, then you would have to run to the rocks and to the mountains, crying for them to fall upon you. That will be tragedy for you. That will be danger for you. You don't want to want to die. Oh God have mercy. You don't want to die and cannot die. For you see, beloved and friends, now is the time to accept the call of God. Now is the time to be prepared for that glorious invasion, so that when Jesus comes, you will be on the Lord's side. Whether you believe in Jesus Christ or not, the second coming of Christ is true, it is literal, it is visible, and it's audible. So my best suggestion to you tonight is to turn to Jesus. For many, many will be sad and lost in the day of the coming of Jesus. The prophet Isaiah describes the group of the saved in the following words. In that day, in Isaiah 25:9, in that day, they will say, surely this is our God. Oh, what do you want to say at the end of life's journey, beloved and friends? Do you want to say, surely this is our God? Or do you want to say, fall on us, rocks and mountains, and hide us from him that sits on the throne? I want you to know tonight that I would rather say, surely, 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 this is our God. We trusted him and he has saved us. This is the Lord. We trusted in him. Let us rejoice and be glad in his salvation. I want to close this little message tonight, but can I remind somebody that Jesus will come and he will not tarry? And whether you believe it, yes or no, the coming of our Lord and Savior is true and faithful. The world as it is cannot last any longer. The world as it is will not be our final dwelling place. I stop by to let somebody know tonight that we are just pilgrims passing through. Our treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue, and the angels beckon me from heaven's open door. And I don't know about you, but with all the crime and violence and kidnapping and accidents and war and diseases that are plaguing our world, this world cannot be our final home. Our final destination is in glory. We are just pilgrims passing through this earth. And while we are passing through, we stop to send a certain sound that Jesus will come. I hear the Bible says in John chapter 14, let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. For in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I've gone to prepare a place for you. And if I go, I will come again, and I will take you with me, that where I am, there you may be also. I stop by to let somebody know tonight that the second coming of Christ may be long, but one thing for certain, it is sure, it is true, and it is faithful. Maybe you've been in the church for so long and you've been hearing about the second coming of Christ. I stop by to let you know that we are closer to the coming of the Lord now than 20 years ago. And anytime soon, Jesus will come. For he says, when you hear of wars and rumors of wars, you ought not to be troubled. Look all around you, and things are happening that has never happened before. He will will come. So my best suggestion to you tonight, that you may choose Jesus and live. Choose Jesus, beloved and friends, so that when he comes, you will be able to say, this is our God who we long waited for, and he has come to save us. I don't know about you, but I want to go home with my Jesus. I'm tired of death and diseases, and I'm tired of pain and sorrow and turmoil. I hear John in Revelation 21. Says that he saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth has passed away. Hear him say in verse number 4 of Revelation 21 that God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, nor sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. Listen to me tonight. There's coming a day when your present situation will be a passed away. There's coming a day, beloved and friends, when that which is bombarding you right now will be a thing of the past. For Jesus will come and take us home to glory. I want to close this little message tonight. I want to close this message, but I stop by to let you know that when all our labor and trials are o'er, and we are safe on that beautiful shore, just be near the Lord Savior we adore, that will through the ages be glory for me. Can I talk to somebody? When by the gift of his infinite grace, I am according in heaven a place, just to be there to look on Jesus' face, will through the ages be glory for me. You see, friends will be there. I loved long ago. Joy like a river around me will flow. Yet just a smile from the Savior I know will through the ages be glory for me. Somebody need to understand tonight, oh, that will be glory for me. Glory for me, glory for me, glory for me. When by his grace I shall look on his face, that will be glory for me. And I just want you to know tonight that now is the time to make your calling and election sure. Now is the time to choose Jesus before he comes to call us home. God wants to save you. Jesus wants to hold you when he comes to take you home to glory. He will come. Let us watch and be ready. He will come. He will come in the clouds of his Father's bright glory, but we know not the hour. But one thing we know for certain, beloved and friends, is that Jesus Christ will come. We don't say this to scare you. We don't say this to cause you to be afraid. We say this so that you can choose Christ now, before it is eternally too late. We say this to bring you hope of a better life. We say this to bring you hope of a better world. Should, in case you want Jesus, you want a better life and you want a better world, oh, the link is in the chat tonight. Won't you go ahead? Click on that link. We want to hear from you. We want to talk with you. We want to help you to make your calling and election sure. so that when Jesus comes, when this great, this real, this awesome invasion takes place, you will be a part of the number that will go marching in. Click that link tonight. Click that link. We want to pray for you. We want to pray with you. For we want to see you saved in God's kingdom. Hell is a real place. Hell is not somewhere that was made for you. Hell was made for the devil and his angels. It's the reason Jesus died on the cross of Calvary to save your soul, to save you that is watching, my brother, to save you that is listening, my sister. And you don't have to die in your sin, because we have a Savior that has died to save you from sin. And that same Jesus will come to call us home. They're going to sing for us. But in the meantime, go ahead. Click that link. Jesus wants to save you.
What a word we have received tonight. We are indeed thankful for the reminder that Jesus will return soon. May we be ready. May we live in readiness. May we all be saved. Please tune your voices with me as we sing hymn number 598. Watch ye saints. Hymn number 598. Watch ye saints with eyelids waking, though the power of heaven are shaking, keep your lamps trimmed and burning, ready for your Lord's returning. The thief comes, who Jesus comes, now he comes.
Jesus comes to reign victorious. Now
proud and stately, Christ his kingdom hasteneth greatly. Earth our latest thanks is summing, shout ye saints, your Lord is coming. Love him, hopes, Lord Jesus comes. Now he comes, oh glorious, Jesus comes to reign victorious. Love him, comes, yes, Jesus comes. Sinners come while Christ is pleading, now for you he's interceding. Is there grace and time diminished? Shall proclaim the mystery finished. Lord, he comes. Lord Jesus comes. Lord, he comes. Jesus comes. Lord, he comes. Yes, Jesus comes.
Amen. Amen. I'm happy to know, beloved and friends, that not long from now, Jesus will come. Not long from now, this world, as it is, will hear the thunderous appearing of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So I charge you tonight, whose side are you on? Where will you find yourself at the great and awesome coming of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ? Deuteronomy chapter 30 and verse 19. I've set before you this day life and death, blessing and cursing. It gives the recommendation, choose life so that you might live. It is my hope and trust that you will click that link. You will choose life so that at the end of life's journey, you'll have a home in glory. Let us pray. Divine God and our Father, we thank you for your reminder tonight. Not a reminder that drives fear or trembling, but a reminder that sparks hope and joy in our hearts. That no matter all that is happening around us, there is coming a day, Father, when you shall put an end to all that is happening. There's coming a day when you shall put an end to the devil and all his doing. And so I pray tonight, Father, for somebody who is listening, who have listened and who will listen tonight, that they will make their calling and election sure before time changes for eternity, before you come to call us home to glory. Dear Lord, as saints, times have been hard upon us. We are longing for your return. The pressures of this life is weighing down on us. And we long, God, to behold you face to face. Oh, I pray in the name of Jesus that when the going gets rough, you will hold us until you come to call us home. We long, Father, for the day to come when the mossy old grave where the pilgrims sleep shall be open as wide as before. Where the millions that sleep in the mighty deep shall live on this earth once more. When the marketplace will be empty and the builder's tools will be silent when there will be no more traffic in the streets. But with one great triumphant voice, we will shout, "The King is coming, the King is coming." And the joy is to know that the King is coming for me. Oh, I pray tonight, Jesus, that you will seal our decision to be saved. And at last, when you shall come, may we have a home in your awesome dwelling. Thank you for your doing. Thank you for grace. And save us, we pray. In the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who will come shortly, we pray and say thanks. Amen and amen.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, Jordan. Wait. We just want to also say a big thank you to everyone who joined us tonight, and we wish you all the blessings that this beautiful Sabbath day will bring you. Do join us tomorrow at 9 as we continue in worship. Have a good night. Thank you.